Hello children, hope you all are doing fine. Now this is the last video before Puja vacation. So today I'm going to teach you all a poem from Poetry Magic again. All of you open page number 16 and you can see there's a poem named Four Scarlet Berries written by Mary Vivian. She is a poetess. Four Scarlet Berries written by Mary Vivian. Now, at first, I'll recite the poem in front of you all. Please listen to it carefully. Please listen to the pronunciation very carefully. After reciting the poem, I'll show you some pictures relating this poem. Okay? So, let's start. Four Scarlet Berries written by Mary Vivian. Four scarlet berries left upon the tree. Thanks, cried the blackbird. These will do for me. He ate numbers 1 and 2, then ate number 3. When he had eaten number 4, there was none to see. Okay. So now I'll show you the pictures. Okay, at first we have came across certain few topics. First one, scarlet. Okay, what is scarlet? Well, children, scarlet is a color. It is a combination of red and orange color. When you can try at home, when we combine red and orange color together, the color we get, that is known as scarlet color. I'll obviously show you the picture of the scarlet color. Let's see. Now children, you have seen the scarlet color. I've shown you in the picture. Now, I'll start the poem. I'll explain the lines in the poem. So the first line is stating, four scarlet berries left upon the tree. Okay, four scarlet berries. How many berries are there in the tree? There are four scarlet berries. Okay, now what are berries? Berries are small fruits which birds like to eat very much. Okay, so how many berries are there in the tree? There are four berries. What color? Four scarlet berries left upon the tree. You can see in the picture given in the poem, there are four scarlet berries upon the tree. Now, before continuing the poem, I would like to show you a picture of berries. You can see it in the poem as well, but I would like to show you a picture of berries. Please see it. I hope you have understood what are berries. So, let's continue the poem. Thanks, cried the blackbird. These will do for me. Now, you can see this is a tree. Now, in this tree, there lived a small black bird who likes to eat berries very much. So, when this bird has seen there are four scarlet berries, she felt very happy. Okay. Thanks, cried the blackbird. This will do for me. He ate numbers 1 and 2. Now, at first, when the bird has seen there are four berries in the tree, the bird felt very happy and he started eating. You can see in the picture one berry. And after finishing one berry, he started again eating the second one. Okay. When he had eaten number 4, there was none to see. Now, while eating the first berry, he liked it very much. Then he started eating the second one. Now, after finishing the second one, the bird started eating the third berry as well as the fourth berry. Now, after eating, there are only four berries. So, he was so happy, he forgot that there were only four berries in the tree. So after finishing the last berry, he started searching more berries in the tree. But as we can see, there are only 4 berries in the tree. So after having the last berry, the bird haven't found any berries in the tree. Okay, so I'll recite the poem once again. Please listen to it. 4 scarlet berries, written by Mary Vivian. 4 scarlet berries left upon the tree. "Thanks," cried the blackbird, "these will do for me." He ate numbers 1 and 2. Then he ate number 3. When he had eaten number 4, there was none to see. Okay, children, before finishing off this poem, I would like to clear one thing. Now, in the second last line, you can see there is he, after that there is an apostrophe S, and beside it there is D. So it is the short form of he had. Okay, we will pronounce this as he had. Okay, so what was written? When he had eaten number 4. This is he had. Clear? So, children, this will be your only homework during the Puja vacation. Learn this poem by heart. You also, in the previous recitation class, I have found many of you have missed telling the poet's name. But in the next recitation class, I would like to hear the poet's name from you all. So you have to learn the name of the poem as well as name of the poet. Okay, so learn this poem by heart. This is the only homework I am giving you. There are no other homeworks from English class. Learn this poem very carefully by heart. Revise the previous lessons if you wish to. And before finishing off this video, I would like to send you all the best wishes of Puja. All of you enjoy your Puja happily at home. Please do not go outside. Okay, you can enjoy in your home only. I know it is very difficult that you won't be able to go outside to see Ma Durga in different pandals, but this time you have to stay at home. You can watch it through TV or phone. Okay, please do not go outside. And one more thing, you can collect information, or you can see various pictures from newspapers as well that comes every morning in our home. Okay, so stay happy all of you, stay safe. See you after Puja. Thank you.